Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today's video is for all the statisticians out there. We are going to go over analysis of variance. So going back to all those stats classes that you may or may not have taken, we want to look at these values down here to see whether or not our set of data for three different drugs has a significant variance or not, to be able to tell if one drug is any better than the other. Oh, and also, at the end of this video, I have some additional Excel training for you, so you may want to stick around for that. So going back to our three different drugs, how do we tell if drug one, drug two, or drug three is better than any of the other drugs? Well, we are going to use analysis of variance to do this. Chances are you don't have the plugin that you need in Excel to be able to run this. So I'm going to go over how to get that into your version of Excel for you. So to get the add-in, go up here to the search bar and type add-ins. And you will see this action down here for add-ins. So just click that and this box will appear. So if you click on Analysis Toolpak and say okay, you will now be able to do analysis of variance in your version of Excel. So next, go to the Data tab and go over here to Data Analysis and scroll up to the top and select the ANOVA Single Factor Analysis Tool and say OK. And let's just select where our data is. Don't select the column headers, but I'm going to start at A2 and go all the way down here to C17. And then under Grouped By, I want to make sure I've selected Columns. And on Output Options, I want to say New Worksheet. And then I'm going to say OK. And I can see that the analysis of my variance in my data has already been created down here. But what does this all mean?
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Well, my F value right here is at a 0.242 and my F critical here is at a 3.204. So if my F value is larger than my F critical value over here, I can usually say that there is something statistically significant about my data. But because my F value here is less than my F critical, there really is no difference in between my three data sets. So I can look here and I can say that none of these drugs are really performing better than any of the others in a way that would be statistically significant. But if I were to return an F value that was higher than my F critical, then I would be able to say that that drug was more significant. So what if I came back to my data and I just made drug three a whole series of low numbers? And what if I run that test again by going to Data Analysis, ANOVA Single Factor, selecting the same data and doing a new worksheet and saying, okay. Here I can see that my F value is way higher than my F critical value. So I know that there is something different in between the drug data that I have on my spreadsheet. So hopefully this gives you a good introduction to using the analysis of variance tool that you can find inside of Microsoft Excel. We have some more information out on our blog about this, and I will include the link below in the description on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.